You know it's time to get up and get moving. If you don't do that, you end up having all of this fat for us to transfer. Okay? I mean, I love transferring fat, but once we transfer the fat, you know how important it is for you not to be creative? You got all right, this way. You know how important it is for you not to be creative?
No.
Yeah, there we go. Because if you do, you're going to keep coming back to us over and over and over again. We don't want that. We want to make people happy. And the way you're made happy is to transform the body that you create back to that body that you remember when you were 25. That's what this is all about. That's what I do. I am the architect of the body. I tell people every time, listen, you know, don't come to me and expect me to do things for you if you're not willing to participate. I cannot do it by myself. So when you come to me, I'm going to sit down, you can ask my consultants, we're going to get into it deep. Okay? There might be a few tears. That's okay. Because I want you to understand something, that you are a participant in transforming your body. I can only do so much. In my non-surgical life, I'm a sculptor. I love to sculpt the human form. I sculpt the face and the bust and all those types of things. And in my surgical life, I like to sculpt. So when I look at your body, I look at your body from an artistic standpoint. You are my canvas. You are my canvas. And the most important thing is to work with a good canvas. And that's where the mind-body connection comes from. The result of my surgery is only as good as the body that is presented. Okay, hold on. I'm the wrong way here. America, the land of the free. What happened to us? What has happened to us? You know, when I was a kid, there was a commercial that used to come on and it said, you are what you eat. You are what you eat. Look at what happens to our food. Read. Refined and processed foods today make up 51% of the things that you put in your mouth. What does that mean? It's in a bag. It's in a can. It's in a box. It has an expiration date on it. But you know what that means? Processed. And the problem with processed foods is that it increases your insulin levels so that most of those foods, which are carbohydrates, will ultimately end up in places that you don't want them to be. And then, you come and see me. Now, it's very important that we consume more dairy and animal foods, because those are the foods that are more natural. I tell people, when you want to go shopping, you want to know what to buy, walk into the store and walk around the perimeter of the store. That's where you shop. You don't shop in the middle. Because in the middle is where all your processed foods are. When you walk into your refrigerator, you should sniff and go, Now, if you've done a good job, you won't smell any bad foods. But if you do smell bad foods, that's also good because it tells you you've got perishable foods. And that's the best way to shop. Having things in your cupboards that are in cans, boxes, and bags is not the way to go. Okay, I know this is tempting. But we're not going to go here, because this is the stuff that creates some bad issues. Now, after you've created a body that you come to me for, there are certain things that we can do. Contouring surgery, abdominal wall reshaping, and that's when we get into liposuction and tummy tucks and different types of contouring. Breast surgery. Now, breast surgery, I not only do breast enhancement types of procedures and rejuvenating types of procedures, but I also do breast reconstruction. Now, there are instances where some patients may end up having an unfortunate situation where they incur breast cancers. I'm also a reconstructive plastic surgeon. So I've done quite a few transfers of belly tissue into the breast, implants into the breast to do reconstruction. So I do a full gamut of breast surgery, torso reshapings. Now, I have this post-bariatric surgery. Now, that's a little bit more extreme. That is when we have patients who have what's called large BMIs, body mass index. The body mass index that typically makes someone eligible for bariatric procedures is greater than 35. And that puts them in a category of severely obese. And obesity today has been designated as a disease. So when you go to your primary care doctor, you actually end up with what's called an ICD-9, which is a diagnostic code that tells your insurance companies that you now have a disease. That's how bad it's gotten in America today, that obesity has become a disease. Liposuction, these are some of the things that we do for body contouring procedures. The most important thing that I said to you, and Dr. Schaefer alluded to this as well, the devices are great. All the tools that we have are great. But if your surgeon doesn't have and understand the aesthetics behind the work, you may not get the kind of result that is important. One of the best commercials that I ever saw, a lady walks in with a faucet, puts it on the desk, and she says, build a house around this faucet. I love that commercial. Because that commercial talks about the artistic ability of that architect. And that's very important, the artist behind the work. We alluded to this. I'm not going to go back into liposuction, some of these cannulas, because Dr. Schaefer covered this very well. But I've also done a lot of laser lipolysis. I came here from an organization in South Florida where we probably did 40 a week. And it was Smart Lipo, one of the largest groups that did Smart Lipo, which is using the laser, which works beautifully to reduce bruising, to reduce swelling, and tighten the skin. It works beautifully. So many times, when someone doesn't want to go to sleep, we can do it under tumescent, local anesthesia, and by far, it's far superior to the basic traditional liposuction. We'll just pass through some of these. Oh, let's go back to this one. This was the body jet, which uses water. And I love this because it takes the water jet at a very, very high pressure, and it separates the fat from the skin. And it works so beautifully because it doesn't create a lot of bleeding. Because sometimes it's the bleeding and the various components that come from those red blood cells that causes the swelling, the pain, and the bruising. So the body jet can sometimes reduce that. We also covered some of these non-invasive procedures because these are wonderful for people who just don't have time to have surgery. You don't want to miss time from work. You know what? I understand that. And so we have devices today that can reduce your downtime and eliminate it, basically, because you don't ever have to go to sleep, and these are non-surgical, no anesthesia, and they're external. I keep going back to this, because, you know, just remember, this is what it's all about. So when you assess your surgeon, you want to make sure that they understand what they're trying to create here. Sometimes when patients have a lot of excess tissue, they also end up having loose skin. There are instances where the devices that we have cannot tighten that skin. And should that happen, this is typically in those patients that I talked about that were requiring bariatric procedures. You really can't tighten that skin. It has to be excised. Now, I once had a patient that was, when I was back in Atlanta, I had this young lady and she had lost about 150 pounds. And I absolutely hated doing thigh lifts and brachioplasties, which is the cutting the skin from the inner arm, because it left these horrific scars. And I refused to do it. And she looked at me and she says, Dr. Bibb, she waved her arm, and the wind that occurred from that flap almost knocked me down. She said, I would rather have that big scar than this. And suddenly it made me understand that there are instances when somebody wants to look better in clothing, they want to be more confident about themselves, there are instances where we have to leave a scar to eliminate a much worse scar, which is the form of their tissues. sometimes we have this type of thing to deal with. And she's much happier without this. Now, this is a combination of, you didn't see the end of the front portion, but sometimes liposuction alone can do this. This was liposuction, this was beta, I'm sorry, this was smart lipo with the laser, which helped with tightness. One of the favorite things that I like to do is to take the fat and put it in places that people always wish they could have. In South Florida, the most exciting operation that we did down there was buttock enhancement. So for a lot of the young ladies who are thinking, and young men too, because we know sometimes that's where the encouragement comes from. But sometimes we can take that fat that people don't like from the flanks, from the thighs, and we can transform the buttocks in such a fashion that suddenly you're close to death. And most designers will tell you, the way the clothes are designed is based on a ratio of the waist to the hips. So the waist-hip ratio is very important. If you want your clothes to fit better, enhance the butt. It works. This is a young lady who experienced... Well, for some reason it's going the wrong way down. But we'll just ignore it. Liposuction. This is a slight tummy tuck. Okay? You can see from the side. Now, this is a tummy tuck. And yes, there's a scar, but if you place that scar where it's supposed to be, as you can see, you can hardly tell where it is. Now, if there's a scar, you will sometimes have to hide it with your clothing. This is a situation where, I'm sorry, but you cannot tie a man with any devices, and unfortunately, you have to excise it. There are a lot of women who come to me and they say, I don't like my stretch marks. You know, I've had twins. And she's not obese, but she's got these horrific stretch marks. So there are things that you can do to excise and get rid of them. I can hide the scars by putting the scars nice and low. The other thing that happens as the body ages, and again, why am I here in transforming human form, is because gravity, we have no treatment for gravity. Okay, unless we wanted to walk on our hands, you're going to have some of the effects of gravity. This is a breast lift to create more volume in the upper fold of the breast. Okay, to sort of get the nipple back where it's supposed to be. There are degrees and parameters that we try to achieve. Like you can see here, we don't want this nipple to be too low. It should not be looking down here. It should be looking up here. So what I try to do is to change that. Body transformation. And these are things that sometimes you can't do much about. And that's where I come to play. You know, that doesn't work. I tried that once, but she got up and she wasn't happy with me. But there are things that we can do for the face. Like this is just liposuction. That's just liposuction. To create a much better angle. And just look at that. Just manipulated her chin. She suddenly looks so much more youthful. And the thing about it is when somebody looks in the mirror and they look more youthful, all of a sudden they feel more youthful and they start becoming more vibrant. Look out, husbands. I hope this isn't your child. Right? And I laugh because, you know, I'll see these children and I'll say to the parent, well, what happened? I said, well, he won't stop eating. I said, well, stop eating. I don't know a five-year-old today that has been able to drive to the McDonald's and order me. I don't know. Maybe kids are becoming more precocious and they steal the cars. And they drive. But parents, come on. Let's not keep doing this right, please, okay? So this is a wake-up call to all our mommies and daddies. We don't want our kids to...